In this video, I'd like to discuss the difference between dynamic variables and static variables. And I've prepared an example to illustrate the different concepts. Here we see a function called totalIt. It takes an integer parameter x. It adds x into a variable called total, which has an initial value of 0, int is total, and it returns the value of total. If we run this program, we will see that the output is 1, 2, 3. And the reason for that is quite simple. The first call to total it with an actual parameter of 1 adds 1 into total. In other words, it adds 1 into 0 and returns a value of 1. The second time we call the function total it, 2, we pass in an actual parameter of 2. We add 2 into 0 because total is recreated, it's reinitialized to 0. We add 2 into 0, getting a value of 2, and we return 2. Similarly, the third time we call total it with an actual parameter of 3 right here, x has a value of 3, total is reinitialized to 0, and total is 0 is added to 3, the value returned is 3, and the output is 3. Total in this case is said to be called a dynamic variable because it is recreated and reinitialized every time the function total it runs. In technical terms, it actually appears on the so-called C++ stack, but that's beyond the level of information we need at this point in the class. What I am going to do, though, is make one small change. I'm going to add the word static in front of the declaration. So instead of int total equals 0, I'm going to write static int total equals 0. And let's compile and run this program. This time you'll notice the behavior is quite different. The output is 1, 3, and 6 instead of 1, 2, and 3. What changed? When I declare a variable to be static, that variable does not go away when the function totalIt returns. In other words, the variable total is allocated a permanent space in the computer's memory. That's why it's called static. It's stationary. It doesn't come and go. It's permanently allocated in the computer's memory. And it's given an initial value of 0. But the initialization only occurs the first time when that memory is allocated, and thereafter, as I said, the memory becomes static. So the first time we call totalIt, the variable total in memory is given an initial value of 0, 1 is added into total, the function returns an integer value of 1. The next time we call totalIt, the actual parameter is 2, but total is not reinitialized. Total in this case is the old value of total that's still sitting in the computer memory, that's statically resident in the computer memory. And total, if you remember from the last call to total it, had a value of 1. So this time we add 2 into 1, and the value that gets stored in total is 3. 2 plus 1 is 3, and 3 is the value returned by the function. The third time we call total it, the actual parameter is 3, x has a value of 3. Total now, again, is not reinitialized, it's static. Static variables are only ever initialized once and once only, the first time they're used. So total now has a value of 3, which is how it was left from the last incarnation of totalIt. 3 plus 3 is 6. Total has a value of 6, and 6 is the value which is returned. So again, if I run this program, you see that behavior. You see the values in total go up, 1, 3, and 6. That's the notion of a static variable, one that's initialized once and once only, and remains in existence the entire time the program runs. Most variables, if you don't use the declaration static, are not static variables. They're called dynamic variables. And they come and go, they come into being and go away again to free up computer memory. They come into being only as and when they're needed. Static variables persist forever, or at least persist for the duration of the program. Thank you.